together in one place. I'm making four different copies. Whatever I tell you, you'll be absolutely crazy. So I'm going to hope you're curious. And if you receive this, both channels, assume the worst. I was about to say, come find my ass, but that's not going to happen. I have regrets.
Greetings and salivations, my patients, and welcome to another day of Gallowtree Hospital Radio. We are the only station that plays exclusively for Gallowtree Hospital ever since WBOR, the big bore internet elevator music provider, became a pay site. So to provide you with that personal touch and to get you through your aches and pains, we provide, free of charge, Gallowtree Hospital Radio, the station that helps you tune up as you tune in. And also note, for a small fee, you can shut off the radio station and watch television instead. You may notice a change in our format. I am Robert York, your new morning host. I'm an immigrant to the fine sovereign city of Gallowtree. To be honest, I've never even heard of Gallowtree until I Google places that speak English as a native tongue and lack any extradition treaty with the United States. And there you are. What a wonderful community. I love the way things are set up here. The quiet town pubs, the way everyone watches me every time I leave my, as you say, flat. The friendly way your bobbies let me know they are watching me. And that mayor of yours, Miss Lorna X, when she speaks, it makes me just a little bit homesick. Not that I'm going home anytime soon. No siree. I'm more than happy to become a full-time citizen of your charming little community. However, when I do head home to visit my friends and family, I'll be sure to tell them all about that magical little burg called Gallowtree in about 15 years, when the statute of limitation expires. But enough about myself. Down to business. I've been putting off starting the show long enough. I have a page here on top labeled Priority Emergency Announcement, or P for short. Dr. Robin Cook, please report to Operating Theater 3 immediately. Your patient has flatlined. And now, back to the music. Up next, announcements. We regret to inform all patrons of Gallowtree Hospital that management cannot be held responsible for any damage done to your vehicle caused by unattended shopping carts. And now, back to the music.
I got a gal who's always late. Anytime we have a date, but I love her.
Up next, the weather forecast. Tonight will be cold with light drizzle and an overcast sky. The new moon will cast no light, thus tonight will be excellent for submarines offshore to disgorge small inflatable watercraft full of agents who will land the long rookery crag. Then, they will climb up the sea cliffs before setting up a listening post where they can observe and relay instructions to any agents that are already walking among us. No, not the new guy who does the radio. This is someone you have known for a very long time, but always suspected of disloyalty to the new order. It's a pity that you are in the hospital where you cannot do anything about him. Isn't that convenient? For him, I mean. What are the chances he's the one who sent you here? Not that anyone would believe you. You know who I'm talking about. I hear he's coming to see you and drop off flowers. A long box of roses that he holds very protectively. It shifts as he walks, as if it contains a great deal more weight than the frail box would normally be expected to hold. Is there a chance he needs to finish something? Are you thinking, how could he allow a loose end to exist while their plans are so close to fruition? You know that needle they stuck in your arm. If you pulled it out, you could use it to strike a vulnerable area. I'm not telling you what course of action to take. I'm just saying your choices are limited to the desperate and unexpected. Tomorrow the rain will clear up by morning, and we can expect a high of 15 by the afternoon. Bit nippy, might want to wear a sweater. And now, back to the music.
Yes, I love her. I'm gonna walk right up to her gate and see if I can get...
Up next, announcements. We ask that anyone who's using parking lot D to please refrain from making protective barriers around their cars using shopping carts. We understand the desire to protect your car from scratches and dings, but making a circle of carts like pioneers circling their wagons while crossing 19th century North America Central Plains eats up about 4 extra parking spaces. Each. Please think about the other patrons and their parking needs. Thank you. And now, back to the music.
It's straight, 'cause I want her. I'm gonna ask her.
Up next, hospital news. Gallowtree Hospital is proud to announce its new advertising slogan, Take Me to Gallowtree. The commercials, which will start rolling out this weekend, are all based around the same theme. People will be shown in dire medical need. The ambulance will then pick them up. The patient will then tell the paramedic, Take me to Gallowtree. This replaces their former slogan, Take me to Gallowtree, unless I have a history of not paying my medical bills, in which case could you drop me off at the free clinic in the zombie district with all the other scum. This caused quite an uproar among the zombie scum workers of Gallowtree. The scum workers' shop steward gave the following statement. Gallowtree depends on zombie scum workers. If it were not for the zombies, who would scrape all the scum off the sewer walls? Who would work in the water purification plant running the scum skimmers? Who would remove scum from the many trees in the forest to confuse the fae that use said trees for navigation and to mark off hunting territory? Someone has to clean up all that scum, and the zombies are more than happy to do it. It's great pay, and the first thing to rot off a zombie is the nose. So the smell isn't really a concern. The Zombie Scum Workers Union is glad that Gallowtree Hospital has finally changed their slogan so zombies will no longer be associated with the deadbeat losers who cannot pay a simple medical bill. Sunrise Financial, Gallowtree's only debt restructuring service, registered a complaint about the Zombie Scum Workers Union's calling people who are in financial crisis deadbeat losers. They think that the Zombie Scum Workers Union would have more sympathy if they only had a pulse. And now, back to the music.
Is you, is, or is you ain't my baby? The way you're acting lately may...
Next up, announcements. It has come to hospital administrators' attention that there have been complaints about the lack of stalls in the parking lots to put shopping carts. This is because the hospital doesn't have any shopping carts. We have no idea where all these shopping carts are coming from. Will the person or persons responsible for all these shopping carts please pick up any white courtesy phone and dial 114 immediately? Thank you. And now, back to the music. Next up, contest entries. We have an entry from the Children's Ward to last week's sing-along music contest. This entry is from Annabelle and the Chemo Kitties. I didn't know that they were running a contest, so I haven't even had a chance to listen to any of the entries. Why don't we both listen to this one together?
Bugs! Bugs! Bugs, bugs! Bugs, bugs, bugs! Bugs, 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 bugs.
Like listening to one of God's own angels. Be sure to log in on the intranet and register your vote on this and other entries. And now, back to the music.
My flame in your heart's done gone out. A woman is a creature that has always been.
Next up, announcements. Gallowtree Hospital is grateful that the shopping carts are gone, but administration would still like to know who was responsible for bringing them here in the first place. If you have any information about the shopping carts, please dial 114. Thank you. And now, back to the music.
Strange, just when you're sure of one, you find she's gone and made a change. Is you is a.
Up next, Memoriam. We are afraid that we must announce the passing of Evan Fowler, who fell victim to an acute case of resisting arrest, which was aggravated by repeatedly tasering himself in an attempt to keep the officers at bay. Apparently, by electrically charging his body, he made it impossible for the officers to safely handle him. For his own safety, the officers were forced to subdue him with the use of their rubber-soled boots and non-conductive wooden batons. Evan was rushed to Gallowtree Hospital, where he stubbornly remained dead on arrival. Officers Daniel Murray and Daniel Duncan were both given commendations for their swift actions taken in the attempt to save the litterbug's life. Oh, hey, those are the guys who keep an eye on me. Hello, Officer Murray and Officer Duncan. Keep up the good work. It's good to know our community is that much safer with fine officers such as you on the job. And now, back to the music.
Is you ain't my baby. Maybe baby's found somebody new. Or is my baby.
Next up, announcements. Paging Dr. Allcall. Paging Dr. Allcall. Please report to the parking garage underground access tunnel. I repeat, please report to the parking garage underground access tunnel. And now, back to the music.
Baby still my baby true.
Up next, mystery diagnosis. This is a contest where a lucky listener gets free medical advice just by sending in a letter. You too can send us a letter by addressing it to Mystery Diagnosis and leaving it in any interdepartmental mail bin. Our question of the day comes from Groovy Wrist. Groovy writes, "Dear Mystery Diagnosis, I came to the hospital to be treated for a sprained wrist and was discharged with a wrist protector to keep it immobile. Everything was fine for the first 2 days, but I seem to have sprouted a tendril. My follow-up appointment isn't for a week, and I'm not sure what to do. It's kind of hairy. It's like it's got an, well, it's definitely got my arm hair all over it. But it's not really skin, per se. More sinew with a few shreds of muscle here and there. It's not that bad. It just sways back and forth. I've noticed it seems to especially enjoy the musical stylings of the hair band Whitesnake. What should I do? Sincerely, Groovy Riz." Dear Groovy, you are just having an allergic reaction. Take a Benadryl and you'll be fine. And now, back to the music. Up next, announcements. Patrons of the hospital may notice that the underground tunnel connecting the hospital to the parking garage has been sealed. You may also notice that the vehicle entrances and exits to the parking garage are currently inaccessible because of several burning cars. We do not think the fire will spread, but we are taking steps to prevent that outcome. If your vehicle is currently in the parking garage or one of the burning cars, we regret to remind you that we are not responsible for any damage caused by unattended shopping carts. And now, back to the music. Up next, making the rounds. Gallowtree Hospital Radio would like to extend a warm welcome to our newest staff member, Mitten the Kitten. Mitten has been adopted by the geriatric wing of the hospital and makes his rounds visiting patients during the night by snuggling up next to them, sitting on their chests, and kneading their flesh with his oh-so-sharp claws that he won't let us get anywhere near to trim. One patient suggested that he should be declawed. Do you have any idea the problems that declawing causes? It's not like they just pull out the claws. Oh no, imagine that they cut the tips of your fingers off up to the second knuckle. Declawed cats frequently display all sorts of neurotic behavior. People then abandon the cat because they find the declawed cats dislike using litter boxes. How would you like to have to scratch gravel with your knuckle stumps? You are a monster for even suggesting it. As for reports that Mitten the Kitten is purposely sitting on chests to slowly draw out the victim's life force, devouring it before them as they lie there paralyzed, forced to watch their very breath coalesce into a tangible white wisp that the kitten then drinks in, is blatant nonsense. The life force of your average geriatric patient is far too feeble to be of any use to Mitten the Kitten. That's why he was adopted from the neonatal care unit. The hospital does deeply regret the series of unfortunate and coincidental crypt deaths during Mitten the Kitten's time spent there. Moving him to another department will be of help to us to determine if Mitten is in some way a soul-eating spirit bound in flesh. Oh my god, he is so cute, by the way. You have got to see him. And I'm talking spelled K-O-O-T. Coot. Check out my Tumblr for a selfie with me and Mittens. And now, back to the music.
My baby. Maybe baby's found somebody new. Or is my baby still my baby true?
Well, that brings us to the end of my shift. It's been an honor and a privilege to be your announcer, and I just want to extend the Jefferson Institute a warm and hearty thank you for the opportunity to work at this facility. I'm looking forward to spending my mornings here for many years to come. Stay tuned for 12 songs from the 1940s that nobody holds royalties to on infinite repeat. This has been Gallowtree Hospital Radio. This has been a fan-created pale imitation of Gallowtree Radio. Gallowtree Radio is wholly owned and in part by Adam Aardvark and Max Black. I hate to inform them, but Aaron A. Aardvark is alphabetically right before Adam in the phone book. Are you seriously going to let that go? Nothing is used with permission. I'm evil and vile and covered with fleas. Is You Is or Is You Ain't My Baby is the 1944 Louis Jordan song and public domain. The background music came with my computer or is free use from Google Play. The writer and voice work were done by me.